We've got a max track that has really simmered down overnight after getting whacked with a round of storms yesterday. We had a number of reports of wind damage. Well, we'll check all that out. Let's talk about what's not happening right now. The storms have fizzled. There's still a little bit in the way of a stray shower or two. Sprinkle cruising across southern counties on the max track. And there you can see the tail end of the storms. That's last evening. And then going up to this morning, the last of those storms washing out down south. So here are all the damage reports. Every one of those little broken trees is an indication of some trees down or some damage. Those are individual wind gusts, and we had a report of a 60 mile per hour gust down in southern Pulaski County and towards northern Wayne County, and also a 64 mile per hour gust out at the airport in Louisville. So yeah, that wind did get cranking, and the concern today is we could see a repeat performance into the afternoon. Also had an impressive round, a complex of storms dive south across Oklahoma and Texas last night, flooding in Missouri and Arkansas. And a round of storms down over Tennessee could hold together enough to impact our central counties as we get into latter parts of this morning. So we'll have to watch out for that. But the main driver is going to be this cold front that's out to the west, and we've got another chance for showers and thundershowers. Strong to severe storms into the afternoon and evening as the final round comes barreling in here. And one indication that that is a possibility, the severe outlook. Marginal risk over to a slight risk across pretty much the majority of the viewing area for later on today from the Storm Prediction Center. We're going to have enough instability building into the afternoon, even if we see that morning round of a few showers and thundershowers, to really get things cranking in the Ohio Valley all the way down into North Georgia and off toward the Mid-Atlantic. Tuesday, Wednesday, the threat shifts west and we get into a much more typical summery pattern. The future track getting a little aggressive with morning showers and thundershowers. I think we'll see a few, mainly south and west, but into the afternoon, this starts you out after lunch and then later in the day, watch out for this. This is where we'll see our better chance for some strong to severe storms. Mid to late afternoon into this evening into our eastern counties, early evening, and then rapidly racing east. The cold front will go through late tonight and early tomorrow morning. On the back end of it, maybe a few lingering showers, but beyond that, this is where we get into the good stuff. 70 degrees now, dew points in the mid 60s. The air is muggy and we're in the 60s and 70s. But look at the highs. In addition to the fact that we will back off the shower and storm chances, we got a good old shot of summer coming. Low to mid 80s to eventually mid to upper 80s. So we'll get up to and then around our average high and maybe even slightly above it. May take a crack at 90 degrees by Thursday and Friday. And of course, what you're not seeing is the lack of showers and thundershowers out there. We've got everything that everybody's been waiting for, an actual chance to have some summery weather around here, some heat, some humidity, and a very low end chance for showers and storms. Maybe isolated to a few Wednesday as a cold front tries to knock on our northern door there as you get up to around Ohio and Indiana. I think it'll hang to our north. So we could string together a 3 to 4 day run with very little going on until showers and storms fire back up again. Scattered stuff this weekend.